from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Congressional hopefuls are appearing on talk shows, meeting with voters on downtown streets and working the phones ahead of Tuesday's primaries to determine which party candidates will appear on November's ballot. Six Republicans and four Democrats are running in Tuesday's primary election to fill the U.S. Senate seat of Olympia Snow. Two Republicans are running in the two primaries for Maine's two congressional districts, and based on the low number of requests for absentee ballots, election officials are predicting a low turnout for the election. Candidates are saying a large number of voters are still undecided, leaving the outcomes up in the air. A demolition of a 200-year-old dam on the Penobscot River got underway this morning. The Great Works Dam is being removed as part of a project aimed at eventually reopening nearly 1,000 miles of river habitat to Atlantic salmon, shad, herring, and other migratory fish species. The $62 million project also calls for moving a dam in VC and building fish passages at two other dams. In exchange for selling the dams to the Penobscot River Trust, the dam's owner was allowed to increase electricity production at its two other dams. The Great Works dams in Old Town will be removed by November, and the entire project will be completed in 2014. Now, the average retail price of a gallon of regular unleaded gas here in Maine has fallen another 8 cents, now down to $3.55 a gallon. The price monitoring website MaineGasPrices.com says prices in Maine have now fallen nearly a quarter in the past month and are a penny below the national average. Industry experts say the falling prices in the region over the past several weeks may be slowing down. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Make sure you check out the other top stories of the day on our website, WMTW.com. Have a great evening.